You know, God is so good. You know, I don't know how many times since I've been down here, I've had went into places, stores, and I've had people come up to me and ask me for money down here. You know, and ask me for something like that. All I see them happen a lot down here. The other day, there was a guy who came up to me in Walmart. The grandgirl will come up with some card money. And he says to me, he says, are you going to town after that way? And I said, no, I'm not going to town after Sarasota. You know, and he's like, well, he's crazy. He has to get to jail because his girlfriend got pulled over. And he's fired by him. He had to get there. Well, you know, people tell you stories like that. You know, I gave the guy $3 to get a bus to go there. When I gave this guy, and whether he used it or not, that's not up to me. But I helped this guy out because of the love I have in Christ. You know, if he used it wrong, that's not him. But, you know, I said to the guy, I said, well, you go to church anymore before I give you $3. And I said, don't give you $3 if you know where you're going to go to heaven. I don't, so I told them how to get there and stuff. You know, and that's all we need to do when people do that kind of stuff.
Yeah, show them the love of Christ.
And I thank God that, you know, those opportunities come into my life. You know, whether I got to give somebody $2 or $1 or whatever, I can tell them a little bit about Jesus and invite them to church, you know. And the guy, he asked me directions on how to get there. So maybe he's going to be there, maybe he's not. But he also said, I'm going to know what you're doing when I come to church. Well, he might be there. Maybe 1 out of 100 people might show up.
Yes.
That's where it's all.
Amen.
You know, there's only one person who does it. You know, and that's happened quite a few times since I've been down there. And I thank the Lord for that. You know? And when I'm down low, a lot of times, and that kind of stuff happens, and I get to witness to somebody like that, and he's picking me up that.
Hallelujah.
And I just thank God for that.
Right.
You know, bringing one person back to Christ covers a multitude of sins. You can't do what happens to rejoicing when you come back to the Lord.
Right.
You don't know who you're going to talk to. You may talk to an angel on the rest. You don't know who you're talking to. You can look like a well on the street and like an angel. Just never asking. You don't know. You got to show the love of Christ to whoever it is. It doesn't matter who it is.
Yeah.
You know, as long as you've got God with you, you're going to be saved. Just show people love and they respond.
No, thank you.
And I just encourage everybody to do that. You know? Just show people love. You know? Show them the love of Christ that they have. You know, bring people to the Lord.
Go ahead. I read this psalm.
Go ahead.
I'm going to read the word.
This psalm's right here. I was in a pretty low place about 4 years ago when I got my motorcycle accident. I had to learn how to walk all over again. I lost a lung. Broke every rib on my left side, my shoulder, the whole place, in the front. I was in a pretty hard place. You know, I was pretty discouraged. And a lady from the Tabernacle up in Cadillac gave me this advice of the Lord, told me to get this to you and help me out. And I was a long time. I want to read the 77th Psalm. For anybody that might be going through a hard time now or in the future, this psalm really helps people out. It says, I cried unto God with my voice, even unto God with my voice, and gave ear, and he gave ear unto me. In the day of my trouble, I sought the Lord. My soul ran in the night and ceased not. My soul refused to be comforted. I remembered God and was troubled. I complained and my spirit was overwhelmed. Selah. Thou holdest my eyes waking. I am so troubled that I cannot speak. I was on so many drugs back then and stuff, painkillers and stuff, that I couldn't talk for at that time for a long time. And I was morphine all the time. I was on pills all the time, all kinds of stuff. And it wasn't good. I have considered the days of old, the years of ancient times. I call to remembrance my song in the night. I commune with my own heart, and my spirit made diligent search. Will the Lord cast off forever?
sometimes those kind of thoughts come through your head. But you like that, you know? You see, mercy, clean off, remember those his promise, fail forevermore. Has God forgotten to be gracious? Hath he in anger shut up his tender mercies? Selah. And I said, this is my infirmity, but I will remember the years of the right hand of the Most High. See, I was raised in church when I was a little kid. My mom and dad brought me up in churches since I was a little boy. Through all this, when I was in hospital over a month, two separate hospitals I had to go to. And the whole time I was in hospital, I was witnessing the surgeons, I was witnessing the doctors. And people kept saying, how can you do this? You almost died. And the Lord almost let you die. I said, no, the Lord didn't almost let me die. The Lord saved my life.
Praise God.
That's what the Lord did. If I wasn't serving the Lord, I wouldn't be here today. And I thank God for that.
Thank you.
You know, God is our protector. He sees me.
Amen.
He didn't cause that accident. The Holy Spirit spoke to me before I went on that motorcycle ride that day, and he told me not to go. But you know what? It was a beautiful fall day, and I thought in my own mind, what's it going to hurt? I didn't listen. And you got to listen to those small voices. When you get a warning, I've been riding motorcycles all my life. I was a little kid. I had dirt bikes, riding tracks, I was doing more road bikes all my life.
Praise
and this one time I just had the feeling not to go. So I was coming down the road, I went anyway. My brother-in-law pulled the bikes up, he had it running, we were ready to go. We went and the accident happened. And I knew something was wrong that day before I went, but I didn't listen. You know? But God seen me
through.
Thank you. God's humbled me. God humbled me that day. A lot. You don't like it. It's a hard thing to say that something happens to a good like that because I live in pain every day from today. And God is so good.
You know, he
brought me from a lowly first place where I'm at today where I can speak his word now. And I can tell people about God. I'm using this as an example.
Praise
you know, I've talked to people that's been on painkillers, got off. I went to Mayo Clinic just a month or so ago, got off every painkiller I was on. Down there, and God seen me through that. The doctors down there said to me, he said, Rick, you're on some of the highest dose painkillers of anybody. We don't know how you're doing it. How you getting through this so well? I said, because I got somebody back.
Hallelujah.
I got God back.
Amen.
They're like, there was people around me going through shakes. There were people around me going through all the withdrawals like that. And when they were checking me, my hands were calm, and they're like, I just don't understand how you can do this. How you have such a peace of heart? And I said, it's God.
Hallelujah.
Savior walks
with
me. Yes.
Thank you, Lord.
I just thank God for that.
Thank you, Lord.
Good God.
Yes,
He is. I will remember those words. Surely I will remember thy wonders of old. I will meditate also of all thy word and talk of thy doings. Thy way, O God, is in the sanctuary. Who is so great a God as our God? Thou art the God that doth wonders.
Yes.
Thou hast declared thy strength among the people. Thou hast with thine arm redeemed thy people, the sons of Jacob and Joseph, saved Salem. The waters saw thee, O God, the waters saw thee. They were afraid. The depths also were troubled. These are miracles that God did in ancient times. We have to remember these things.
Oh, yeah.
When our times are getting hard and stuff, we got to remember who our Savior is and who does these miracles. He does them today like he did back then.
Amen.
I'm here telling you. The fowl poured out water, the sky sent out a sound, thine arrows also went abroad. The voice of thy thunder was in the heaven. The lightnings lightened the world, the earth trembled and shook. Thy way is in the sea, and thy path in the great waters, and thy footsteps are not known. Thou leadest thy people like a flock by the hand of Moses and Aaron. God saw these people through the desert. He led them to the promised land, and he'll lead you and us to the promised land.
Yes, he will.
Amen.
God will see us through trouble, the day of his coming.
Yes.
Amen.
I just thank God that he has the strength to see us through our
lives.
I just thank God for that scripture. I thank God that woman brought that to me that time. You know, I have broken bones, and I just asked God to be with me, and I had a broken spirit. At that time, he just lifted me up, and that lady looked at me, and the Holy Spirit was with me the whole time. I was just in a low place, and then I'll get there. But you know, God had to really bring us back out. All we got to do is stay strong and stay faithful. And I just thank God for that.
Praise